bunch of suggestions. We're definitely going to use at least some of them. We may wind up using all of them at some point. Somebody might get a suggestion, and somebody else might take it and use it for their thing. You'll see how it works. But anyway, why don't you get started, Stephen?
All right. Something you want to overcome.
Fear.
Fear. All
right. Tell me an emotional problem that I have.
Debt issues.
Depression. Depression.
Something that you might be seeking in life.
Money.
A block you might have that might stop you from reaching your heart's desire.
Fear of sex.
Fear of sex, okay. Something you wish your family would just stop doing.
Voting Republican.
Problem you had in high school that you still have today.
I need an issue that you might be trying to work out.
I still don't have a job.
Being unemployed. Or was that your personal confession? Okay, so let's just review those real quick.
Fear.
Depressed.
Seeking money. Fear of sex. Voting Republican.
Being unattractive.
Being unemployed. Welcome to the Wizard of Odds. Might make it a joke. We just met. Actually, we haven't really even met yet. Now.
Margaret Harris.
That's a beautiful name. You Catholic?
Yes.
That's nice. I like where this is going. Strange, like freaky strange?
No.
Alright.
I just... Would you mind touching my eyes?
Well, what?
Just for about 2 seconds. And then we'll be done.
So some particular kind of touch you want?
A light touch.
Fingers.
Well, you mentioned my eyes being beautiful, so I thought you might want to touch them.
I'd like to make you happy, you know? So if that makes you happy, then yeah.
Well,
it's a good stop.
Yeah.
It was so sweet.
You know, I do not like it when you call me creepy. Okay?
Sorry, babe.
Do not call me baby, because it's completely inappropriate, look. Well, you clean it, it's a terrible, terrible mess.
Charlotte, I told you, I came out here to clean it earlier, but the sun's so bright, and it kind of makes me sad.
Listen. If this relationship is going to continue to happen, you need to be here when I need you, okay? You need to comply with the things that I have set forth for us in terms of this relationship to work. Do you understand what I'm saying? There are leaves in the pollen. How can I get my tan if I know that there are frogs and leaves and snakes and I don't know what else in there, okay?
Sorry, I lost the checklist and sometimes I just forget, you know? I'm really stupid.
You can do better, okay? I'm sure of it. I'm sure you can do better, okay? But I'm going to cut your salary in half for this month and it's just how it's going to have to happen. You'll be fine, okay?
But I'm not going to be able to afford food for my gerbils.
Oh, hopefully someday you can aspire to have the kind of wealth that I have. You can, for a very short period of time. It's really something, and you know, not everybody can do what I've done here, but I think if you watch me for very many years, you will slowly learn.
I don't want to be on YouTube.
Do not stand up for to me.
But that's what you do. Yeah.
And it's not YouTube, okay? I am an icon.
You make money from people clicking the ads before the YouTube videos. The ones that make everybody so angry. They don't make me angry though. They make me sad. All those happy families. And
have you started?
Started what?
Talking.
You know I don't talk.
I know, Randolph.
I'm a truck. I'm going to talk on my seatbelt.
It's part of the problem.
I want to remain anonymous, except for my hand.
And what's your hand?
Ugly truck. It's Doug Kirk, come on.
You put your CV up to your ear? Because you're afraid that you're going to be rejected by your own CB radio.
No, in answer to your question,
yeah.
Yes. Remember what you asked me?
I've asked you a lot of things, Randolph.
You said you put your CB up to your ear.
Yeah,
that's a pretty stupid thing, Dr. Holbeck.
All duck.
You done here?
No, we'll sit here for another 35 minutes in silence. That's what it's going to take. 2 years of this, Randolph, 2 years of you feeling as if you're ugly.
You said duck.
I said feeling. Need to embrace it.
This is a great one.
Ah.
Where is it? We have coffee, the little plastic cup. You don't need to know how to make coffee. You just put a little cup in. And
I know how to make coffee. I'm an American.
Seemingly, what you just said is, an oxymoron, but you know. My point is, you don't need to know how to make coffee. If someone wants coffee, if you want coffee, just put it up in the machine and press the button. But you know how to use it, so
yeah,
it's so fine.
Yes,
and
great.
Our snakes, you know, they're fine. They're for all of us, you know, and in the school.
Okay.
Sure, and there's more to see.
All right. Is there like a non-immigrant that could be giving me this tour? Oh, hello, darling. Who is this?
This is a new woman.
Oh, look, she's gorgeous. You would do so well here, my darling. Can I show you around? It's so nice of you.
I'm showing you around right now.
Have you learned how to make coffee? No, not yet. But you're very pretty, so please show me.
Saying you put the cup in and you push it out there, you know.
It's very brilliant. You're going to love working here, and I think we're going to love working together.
We all love working together.
Yeah,
I'll get used to it.
Oh,
sure.
It's going to be brilliant.
Brilliant. Magnifique.
You got some money.
You can do this.
I'm hungry.
And it's probably not entirely your fault.
God bless you.
Okay, you can do this.
Okay. Ma'am, I'm hungry. That's only a dollar.
Only a dollar?
That's
a
not
dollar.
Buy me much. I'm hungry. I'm very hungry.
Maybe it is.
I'm sorry, I can't hear you.
Nothing. I said it's a dollar you could have earned, but we're gonna let that go.
God bless you.
I have eaten apple.
I'm allergic to apples. I'm so hungry. Please, just another dollar, ma'am.
And a quarter of a banana.
I'm allergic to
Brandy. I don't know what you. I don't know which kind of rake you're supposed to use for those kind of leaves. She's insistent I've got to rake them up this week. I put it off 4 times.
I think you need to use the one with all the tines on it.
You know what?
The one that says leaf rake on it.
I really don't need this kind of thing from a friend right now.
I'm trying to help you. Like you're trying to help me. Sort of.
I can read the signs that are on the friggin' rakes.
Well, you didn't act like. Just get this one. That's fine. That'll do good.
You seem like you don't care about the rakes or anything that I'm doing lately.
No, I care, but you know, I have problems of my own.
Maybe I should get a leaf blower.
Otter noisy. Yeah. I hate them things. You know, I saw some guy with a leaf blower. I ran him over with my truck. He was right close to the curb there, and I just brushed on by. I didn't blow him the right way. The wind kind of pushed him over, and I might have hit him a little bit. But he was fine. He got up enough to swear at me and stuff as I went by. After I went by.
A I love your stories, man.
I got a lot of them. Where are you going?
I just feel that, you know, until I've reached a certain accumulative amount, I just don't feel like it's enough, like I've really done what I was put on the earth to do. And, you know, although I have a mansion and I have pools, I got a blood clot, I might have to fire it, but you know, I have all of these things, and I just feel like, you know, there's something out there for me that's going to really bring in the big bucks. And so, you know, I think that that's what I'm hoping to get at. Excuse me.
You too. You're avoiding the fucking issue.
Maybe how I got my start.
That's, you got all your life. You too.
It's a very, it's a, you know, I feel like I want to reject that. That's like, is that a good word to use? I'm
that's
rejecting.
Fine.
I want to reject you saying.
Well, transfer it back to me. Whatever you want to do with it, that's fine. I'm gonna just get it right back. Dig it out of the ground, put it into the pool where you're swimming. Put your tank and your money from
Thank you.
Hey, could you do me a favor?
Oh, sure.
Could you maybe just like slap me in the face?
Yeah. I'm looking at the carpet.
I've seen better days. You know, it's well worn, probably a carpet that looks like my face. Not looking, looking out of the water. You know, it's pretty. It's pretty. It's,
you're at the water.
Yeah. I'm looking at the water. You know, I'm just thinking how pretty it is. I was thinking, you know, sometime I would like to, you know, I don't want to be forward or nothing, but.
Why can't go?
What?
Hey, I think you got disconnected.
I was just gonna say, you know, hey, sometime you want to.
I think we're about to get.
Alright, now listen, Austin, fine. Let me say it real fast before we get disconnected. Yep.
Okay, fine. Yes, bye.
Yeah.
and we have idiotic cartoon characters in French who sound like American assholes, so. But the point is, my friend, I think you and I are on the same side. You know, people hear my French accents and say, oh, you must have everyone, you know, except everyone with your heart, you know. That's, no, no, I enjoy to hate people.
This hate makes me more attractive.
Well, I wanted to ask her about it. Well, all right. are maybe in a non-sexual way. maybe you would like to be platonic friends later.
Hold on! What the hell are you talking about?
Knee is like meat on the hoof or what?
Meat on the hoof. That's what your mama told me. She said, you're meat on the hoof. That's what I like about you. She told me she I was handsome too, but that's bullshit.
All my friends tell me I'm too ugly to get a girl.
Son, so hold on.
Daddy, you really ought to use that little wheelie there.
Look here, son, you look at me. I'm your daddy. You think I'm ugly? Hold on.
Just mom.
Billy! Don't drink no more beer. Do you think I'm ugly? The correct answer is no.
You have a warm heart, dude. You gonna hit me?
No. Not right now. Maybe later.
You don't have a beard, dude?
Yes.
Thank you.
So does your have to work on Friday?
Yeah. So good. Yeah, it's been a long time since I've had good old American bourbon. Because anything else is un-American.
By definition, bourbon is American unless you're talking about bourbon. Yeah.
I didn't understand that.
It's all right. You're very dense for man.
Yeah, well...
Seems so uncomfortable.
I'm trying to be nicer.
Why?
Because apparently I'm not nice. But I promised my parents I would be nicer.
You never struck me as
quote, very nice. Less bitchy.
Never struck me as very nice at all.
Are you using this extra chair?
Yes.
Is there someone sitting? I've been.
Yes. Yes. No, they're late, but they're coming here.
Are you sure?
They're part of our living zone.
Yeah. Like he said.
Part of our living zone.
Hey, do you like gerbils?
Sorry?
Do you like gerbils?
No.
You remind me of a gerbil that I have.
I feel really badly about slapping you.
It was another great night. Thanks, Margaret. I appreciate it. I've enjoyed so much spending time with you.
Thank you.
So, you know, good night.
Good night.
Shake. You know, my father told me it was a man actually shouldn't offer his hand to a woman, that he should wait for her to offer her hand. My father.
You're right.
Mouthful exercises.
Oh, really?
Yeah, for
TMJ. Your beauty, probably. TMJ?
Yeah. A jaw issue.
Oh. Is it painful?
Very painful. I think we shouldn't see each other again. So embarrassingly horrifying and painful. Good night now. Have a good life. Thank you.
But Margaret. Dale.
Well, I suggested you get Botox. And I know that costs a lot of money, but I'm willing to work the extra shifts.
At the meal.
Wow. He's got daggers for eyes.
Well, he's Dr. Holbeck.
Hold on. So Botox, do you feel like this will make him handsome? Again?
Well, I'd try anything if you had a different suggestion.
How come you ain't like this?
That what he does?
Yeah.
It's because
he's always done it on my
life. That's why I'm listening.
He probably hurt himself.
Maybe he's trying to be respectful for the woman. And that would be.
No.
Why did you find him handsome?
Why did you find me handsome?
What was it about Randolph that you found?
What was it about me?
Hey, she can hear me, Randolph.
Well, I don't know. I guess he just sort of had a little twinkle in his eye that just drew me in.
Stand up, Randolph. Stand up.
I'm going to have to do something embarrassing.
He does that by himself. I'm going to do that. Just walk right now. Just walk from the sides that back and forth.
Jesus.
Alright. Well, what were you gonna sit down?
Yeah, why not?
Because I wasn't finished. How old are you right now?
47.
How old were you when you met him?
21.
Oh, you're right. What were you doing when you were 21, Randolph? Not that.
I was just had my first truck.
Alright.
Because I worked for a while at the mill where I met her.
Start walking.
And then I saw her and I said, she's beautiful. I really like to get to know her. And then I said, oh.
Yeah, that's a wall. I just like to watch it.
Okay, another way.
Yep, that's what I'm talking
about. All right, so I keep my eyes closed.
Yep.
All right, so I saw her at the meal, and she was real beautiful, and I asked her to marry me, and she said...
All right, stop. Keep your eyes closed, ask her to marry you.
Oh, we don't need to do it.
Ask her to marry
you. Please.
Ask her to marry
me. Please marry me.
No, Randolph, not
I know I'm an ugly man.
I'm down here, darling. Randolph, I can't see you.
Tell me to sit down. Where are you?
I'm right here.
Those are your legs?
That's my knee and these are my hands.
What else you got?
Oh. I feel like I want more guidance other than my therapist. Well, part of exploring sex is loving yourself and feeling beautiful. Did you remember for your hand mirror? Unfortunately, I did. It's a compact. He can work with that. Okay. Now, have you seen your vagina before? No. I don't want to look down there. It's important.
That was hot!
competitive?
But I wasn't scared of it.
No, you were drawn to it.
But even if I was scared of it, it would have been okay.
Yeah.
It's like a double prize.
Double, yeah, it's a great way of looking at it. Two prizes in one.
Dr. Bullhite, I never could have gotten here without you.
I know.
Sometimes I questioned you. Sometimes I thought you had no idea what you were doing. Sometimes I thought you were aggressive on the line of being abusive.
That is true.
But your methods work.
I know.
I wanted to show you my
You want to hear, Mama? I got some announcements to make.
Oh, God, there's another one coming.
What?
You're going to have another
one. Y'all, you, what?
Haven't you pregnant?
No.
I'm pregnant.
That's true.
She is.
She is.
I am 45 years old. So.
Thank you.
Miracles happen.
You all just hate it.
No. Daddy, what's up?
What, please?
Did you get any milk? That's a big surprise.
No. Your mama and I are going to renew our vows that we never had because we're common law married.
That means we're going to have a wedding.
We're going to get hitched. And you guys are all going to be legitimate. I learned that word from you when we were talking about the platins.
Yep.
Or whatever they were.
Is it retroactive, big?
So, son, nothing we can do about it. You're all born out of
wedlock.
You're all bastards.
That's what I was
going to ask. Do we get to have a party?
Well, not a party.
Well, you know, maybe we can have a party and a shower at the same time. Or maybe just, if you pop, like, right away, we can just
have
a
water drop.
Yeah, birth thing. Yeah. Like a party. Kind
all of. Right, that sounds
and
good.
You know what? I get you all the milk you can drink.
Daddy looks different. I like him now.
Randolph, you're a good daddy.
I know. I may be ugly. I'm
a good daddy. Not to me. It's not anymore, honey.
Only half of it, isn't it?
Welcome to that freaking gerbil show. That name change has been an inspiration lately. Been talking to the gerbils. And, and also talking to people, it's been very interesting. Today we're going to listen to Natalie and Sylvester have a conversation.
It's the best date night.
And then Sylvester's like, I don't know. Maybe we should go eat.
I don't want to.
Sylvester's like, we should get married.
But we can't get married, it's just gerbils.
You're very logical for a rodent.
I'm kind of hungry, maybe we can eat our kids later.
All that misery.
The doctor says I will be walking again in a week.
That's good to hear. Can I engine you after
that? Yes, in fact, since I can't walk, how would you like to walk on me right now?
Poor young woman. I didn't know if you knew I was here. This is my associate.
I'm his therapist.
She's my therapist. You can leave now.
Bye.
I just wanted you to see how I did one session.
Thank you for that.
They were brand new. Just.
How are you?
Horrible. So much shit.